Hey guys, this is Armas from Speedemy. I wanted to show you real quick what is the most useful tool in MySQL performance optimization practice. More specifically, I will show you how to perform a MySQL query optimization. That is, how to properly log your slow queries and how to properly analyze the slow query log. Many DBAs are spending like most of their time on MySQL configuration file, OS configuration, hardware, and yet most of the gains come from a properly executed query optimization. The insights you can get from a good slow query log analysis is just priceless, and in all of my performance optimization engagements, this is where I spend 70 to 80% of my time. So let's start. If you want to do it with me, feel free to stop the video as we go. Otherwise, you can just watch the video now, and as we finish this advanced MySQL slow query logging tutorial, you'll get a cheat sheet to all the links and all the tools that we're going to be using throughout this tutorial. I am going to be using a Percona server for this demonstration, just because it's the richest MySQL distribution when it comes to slow query log, and it happens to be the version of MySQL used by the customer I'm working with here. I will show you the difference between Percona server and MySQL slow query log as we go, but you can use MySQL Community Edition, Enterprise MySQL, MariaDB or WebScale SQL just as fine. First thing you want to do is check the current status of the slow query log. I typically run the following command to get both the status of slow query log variable and also slow query log file for the location of the slow query log. In this case, you can see the slow query logging is on, and here's the location of the slow query log. Before I start a new logging session, first thing I do is I rotate the slow query log. Why? Because the current slow query log may contain really, really slow queries logged months ago that I'm not interested in, yet it would skew my report. Here's how you can rotate the log. And now we have a fresh new log. If you don't have a new log yet, query logging is probably not enabled, so you want to run the following command. Let's now do a basic demonstration. For that, we want to tackle long query time. Long query time controls how long a query needs to take for it to get logged to the slow query log. You might be tempted to set this to like 1 or 2 seconds, and in fact, the default value is 10 seconds. But I highly recommend you set this to 0 and get all of the queries logged. I know, it doesn't seem to make sense at first, but that's only because you are used to looking at slow query log as a file you scroll through to find slow queries. That's a wrong way to do it, and here's why. If you only look at queries that take more than, say, 1 second, you miss all these 10, 100, or 500 millisecond queries, yet there could be hundreds of them running per second, consuming lots of resources. And as you know, generating a single web page often takes 10, 15 MySQL queries. And even if all those queries take 5 seconds combined, you won't see them logged if neither of them takes more than 1 second individually. This is really important, so let me say that again. If you only look at the queries that take 1 second, you miss all those 10, 100, or 500 millisecond queries. Yet there could be hundreds of them running per second, consuming lots of resources. So let's set long query time to 0. Beware of a couple of things. 1. By default, in Percona server and in MySQL always, changing long query time will only impact newly created connections. All previous connections will still have long query time set to the previous value. That's especially important if you're using persistent connections. 2. If you have 5,000 or more queries per second, you should be cautious with that. Watch the size of the slow query log. And if you're running Percona server, you may want to consider setting log slow rate limit to, say, 10, combined with long query time equals 0. I will talk a bit more about log slow rate limit in this tutorial later on. Now that you have started logging, watch the slow query log size. Once you have logged it long enough, say for 30 minutes, or it's over a gigabyte or 2 in size, you want to stop logging. Let's stop the logging entirely with set global slow query log equals 0 command. Finally, let's make sense of this huge slow query log. You want to download PT Query Digest if you don't have it yet. Alternatively, you can install Percona Toolkit that includes this and many other cool tools. And now simply run the following command. What PT Query Digest is doing now with the default configuration is it is grouping all of the queries in the log by their fingerprint. A fingerprint is an abstracted version of the query text with literals removed, white space collapsed, and so forth. So basically, different instances of the same query will be considered as if it was the same query and all stats for them will be aggregated. This is incredibly useful because that way you can see which queries is MySQL spending most time on. And that way, even the really fast queries will get correctly identified as resource intensive if they are executed often enough. Whereas with long query time equals 1, you wouldn't see them in the slow query log at all. In part 2, we are going to go over this report line by line. I will show you what are the key areas to focus on and how you can quickly tell exactly how much impact does a specific query have to the overall server utilization. Please subscribe to get notified when part 2 becomes available. And if it's already there, you should see the link in the notes. This was Oremas from Speedemy. Thank you for watching.